If you read the RBI statement which they released with the policy, I think there were two important things. First of all, the governor did say that they were expecting inflation to come off till about September, and then there may be a gradual pickup. So the trajectory was expected. But as you said, I think what is important is that the decline in the two inflation rates, yesterday's CPI number and today's WPI number, is far more steep than what people are expecting. So I think that rather than just the fact that WPI and CPI are down, it's the amount of the decline which offers hope that the Reserve Bank has more space to cut rates. And if you remember, once again, they had made a slightly hawkish statement. But now if this sort of inflation reduction momentum continues, there is a case for taking a fresh look at the inflation dynamics. I think for the past several quarters, the RBI has said that the current account deficit is a parameter which it is looking at closely. And as you know, it's at a record high. You know, it's far more than what we even had in the 1991 crisis. So yes, the trade numbers are a worry. Secondly, if you look at the inflation numbers, the drop in core inflation shows that there is demand destruction in the economy. So that's another thing you have to consider. And third, you know, even as we celebrate the decline in inflation, what we are looking at is inflation in April versus inflation in March. But if you look at inflation across the world, and the only number, comparable number, is the consumer price inflation, because that's what most countries track, you'll see that India's consumer price inflation is still at least double of what it is in other developing countries. I mean, forget the advanced countries which are have very low inflation rates, but even if you look at China, Brazil, Russia, Indonesia, they have inflation rates, or consumer price inflation rates, in the range of 4 to 6%. We are at least 3-3.5 percentage points above that. So we still have inflationary pressures. The trend is positive, but let's not kid ourselves in believing that the inflation problem has been beaten.